American legacy from slavery to freedom. It's a program she's created, and she's been performing this for the Elder Hostel program since 1984. And this program is very touching. I've seen it many times, and every time I'm moved by Sylvia. And please join me in welcoming Sylvia Tabb Lee.
Somebody else. It becomes an issue of color. Let's talk about days of those, huh?
Jamestown, 1607. When did you get here? Today is Monday. You got here yesterday? Have you been to Jamestown?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes or no? Some of you have been because you've been here before. Jamestown, 1607. The first permanent English settlement. When the English arrived,
they were looking for gold.
They found hard times. They couldn't grow anything because they were not accustomed to working the land. These were men who were accustomed to working their heads. Out of 104 men and boys, they were craftsmen, gentrymen. Not quite gentry, but upper middling sort. 1608, out of 500 men and boys, 60 survived the winter. They had to depend on the Indians to grow things. They found bad water. They couldn't grow anything. Marshland, diseases, military bombardment. 1619, three things happened. First House of Burgesses, here at Jamestown. And the first women arrived. Indies to Virginia was 3 weeks to 3 months. The boat was cleaned once a week. And they brought people between the ages of 12 and 25. Men were placed in the hold, women and children in the middle, ship captains on deck. See, when they decided that tobacco would make them wealthy, they looked around and they said, the Indians are here. The Indians knew the land. They said, we're out of here, bye. Then they brought white indentures over from England. The white said, we don't want to work this. Tobacco is hard. You don't live long on a tobacco plantation. 5 years is good. 5 years. Whites are running away, changing their names. Masters can't find them. African people, we certainly don't blend in. Know how to do the work. Certainly easy to find. The African slave trade continues. This is loose packing on a slave ship, Kansas. This is lying on your back, wrists and ankles, chain, loose packing. Say loose packing.
Loose packing.
The boat is clean once a week. Ladies, please turn your body down. Lying on their side, someone between each of them turned the other way, is tight packing. Say tight packing.
Tight packing.
The boat is cleaned every other week. Where's the bathroom? What did you bring with you? Empty-handed? I'm not empty-handed. Message? Nobody can take your brain away. Our children need to know that. They need to know that your brain is something that nobody can take. Your clothing, your carts, your carriages, your shelter can be taken away. Not your brain. That's what's keeping you through Middle Passage. Your music and your dance and your stories and your religion is your strength. Your spirituality may not be religious, but you're spiritual. That is your survival. Give them a hand as they take their seats. My grandmother was a wise woman. Children don't understand wisdom until they get old like her. My children are teenagers.